And now we will learn how to manage leases in QuickBooks. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What happens in QuickBooks during a lease? Well, you first enter the main lease information into the lease document. That was the estimate that we set up in the previous video. You can add any details from the contract that you need to always remember in the memo field or the description field of the estimate. Any other long-term information about the lease should be kept in the notes section of the customer center in the tenant's records. You can attach a photocopy of the actual lease from the paperclip icon in the ribbon of the lease window. So if you have the whole contract scanned in, you can attach it to the lease that you're making in QuickBooks. Now, once your lease document is all set up, all you have to do is open the lease each month to record a monthly invoice against the lease. That's it. There's no other setup information, and there's nothing else to do but act normally each month, and then QuickBooks will give you those reports about your lease. For example, let's imagine on June 1, we made a lease with Ellen for 24 months, same rent, $2,000 per month. That's all you need to put into QuickBooks. Everything else will be on the actual lease document that you can scan in and attach, or you can type in the details into any of the fields in the estimate or the customer center. From the main menu, we click Customers, Create Estimate. And we have to make sure that the estimate that we choose is lease. This way, we know it's a lease. We can close this panel. We're familiar with QuickBooks documents. We were going forward in time, so I believe the date of the lease was June 1 of 2020. And the tenant that we had the lease with is Ellen. Now, watch how we do it. We choose the rent item, the same one that's connected to rental income. However, because the instructions specifically say 24 months, that means that we have to put the number 24 here, and the rate is Ellen's monthly rent, $2,000. So this is a $48,000 lease. It's a $48,000 estimate because it's $2,000 a month for 24 months. That's all you have to do. If there were important details that you had to remind yourself of every month, you should put it here in the customer message or here on the memo, or even type it into one of the lines of the description field, even if you don't have another item to put, because you're going to reopen this estimate every single month. Click Save and Close. Now, the estimate is not a transaction, and it will not show up on any reports that have an effect on your balances. But the lease will show up in two places that you could use to reopen the lease to be able to enter the monthly invoices. First, one of the reports that we set up in the previous video was percent progress on leases. That estimate is there even though it's 0%. And you can double click and then click Create Invoice, and whatever invoice you create from this window will be matched against this lease. The other place you can look is here in the tenant's records. If you click the tenant's records and then click in the left panel on the particular tenant, you will not see the lease if you're showing transactions, even if you're showing all transactions. You have to click the all transactions, the show pull down actually, and actually click estimates, and then the estimate will show up. And then you can double click, and then once the estimate is in front of you, you can click Create Invoice. Now, if the lease happened on June 20, then the first invoice we create will be dated June 30. So we don't want to create it for the entire estimate or even a percent. We want to create it for selected items. Selected items is what you have to choose because we're doing the monthly rent one of 24 months. We click OK and we get this window. Specify invoice amounts for items on estimate. So we want to show quantity and rate by clicking here. We could even show percent, but it wouldn't help us, but we might as well show it because it gives us more information. But the quantity here, we'll stretch the column. Quantity is zero. Now what we're going to do every time we put in an invoice against this lease, we're going to change the quantity by one and push the tab key. And now we can see each month is only 4.17% of the entire lease. We click OK and we notice 1 month came onto the lease for the invoice, came onto the invoice, and this monthly invoice is 2000. And again, the proper date in this case is June 30 of 2020, so that we know we're going forward in time 1 month at a time. Now, don't forget to choose the correct receivables account. I think it's rent receivable. I think Ella's a little behind. If you don't remember, you have to check your rent report, but let's just put it in rent receivable for now. We don't want to get sidetracked. Just click save and close. And now when we open up the lease reports, we can see percent progress on lease is 4.17%. And we can also see the money amounts of the lease. Here's the total of the lease, and here's the total that has been billed and earned from that particular lease. And these numbers, progress invoice and percent progress, will increase. Progress invoice will increase 2,000 a month, and percent progress will increase by 4.17 a month until we get to 100% and $48,000. If you want to see how many months have gone by in the lease, just double click and go back to the estimate. And even if you're not creating an invoice yet for the next month, you can still click create invoice for selected items, then click OK, because this window will show you what has been done prior, or the prior quantity. So we only have one prior month so far. Let's imagine we're going to make the July 31st invoice for the next month against this lease. We would click create invoice from the very same lease window. Then we would click down here again and click OK. Now prior is one, but the current quantity in July is one. One more month's worth of staying during the lease, which brings the total up to 8.33% of the lease finished. When we click OK, we say that 8.33% of the lease is finished as of the day we're billing. Now in this case, it's the end of the next month, July 31st. Now when we click save and close, and we look at the percent progress on the lease, we now see it's immediately updated. The total of the lease was 48,000, but the total that has been billed is 4,000 because that's the amount that was actually earned. And now we have 8.33% progress on the lease. One more time for August 31st. Double click, click create invoice, make sure it's selected items. Now look, prior says two prior months totaling 8.33%. This is one more month because it's one more invoice against this lease. Click OK, and now we're up to 12.5% complete, but that's at the end of August. So that at the end of the third of 24 months, we're 12.5% complete, and the prior amount is 4,000. After we save this invoice, the prior amount is going to go up to 6,000. Click save and close, and now again, we've invoiced 6,000 because that's what we've earned against the $48,000 lease, and this is the percent progress.